Good morning and happy Sabbath, children. Welcome back to another amazing children's sermon. And our theme for this month is the new faith. And our topic for today is
the gospel message in Antioch.
And our verse for today is Acts chapter 11, verse 26. And it says, and the disciples were called Christian first in Antioch.
Let's pray. Our God and our Father, we do come before you this moment, appreciating for the gift of life. As we are going to deliver your message to your children, please help them understand. And for it is in Jesus' name we do pray and believe. Amen.
Dear boys and girls, do you remember the game telephone? Where one whispers a word into your ears, and you must tell your friends what you have heard. The friend tell another friend until you reach the end of the line.
Well, I do. And today we are going to play the game in real life. Except for the fact Noah says the wrong thing. The players are guided by the Holy Spirit to spread the gospel all across the nations.
Better yet, the parable of a mustard seed, where a man plants a small seed and it grows the largest among the old garden plant, with such big branches that the birds can perch in its side. Well, the disciples are the small seed and the mustard seed are the believers across the world.
As God used the disciples to spread the gospel, even today, he is looking for not only the ministers, but also physicians, nurses, literature evangelists, Bible workers, and all with different talents to go to the cities of today.
Yes, children, the examples of the followers of Christ in Antioch should be an inspiration to every one of us living in the great cities of this world today and bring our wanderer home.
We have learned how the spreading of gospel started. Today, let us learn how the gospel grew in one of the ancient big cities in the world, which is Antioch.
The disciples traveled across the world delivering good news. Some went as far as Phoenice, Cyprus, and Antioch. But for today, where's our focus?
Today, we want to spotlight and zoom the city of Antioch.
Antioch was favorably known as a resort for those who loved easy things and pleasure because of where it was located.
Yes, listen boys and listen girls, Antioch has beautiful surroundings, all the wealth, culture, refinement, all are found there. In the days of the apostle, it had become a city of luxury and wicked behavior.
Wait, would you compare it with any other city today?
But of course, why not? If it were to be compared, it would be a blend of Dubai and Mombasa.
Even though it was wicked, God has placed his hand upon them and a great number of believers turned to Christ.
This reminds me of a Swahili proverb that says, Chema cha jiuza kibaya cha jitembeza. Without them knowing this, the message reached the church far and wide, and more helpers like Barnabas were sent to assist.
When Barnabas arrived in Antioch, he saw the grace of God and he was glad. He gave encouragement to those who decided to follow Christ and strengthen their faith.
The good work of Barnabas in Antioch was richly blessed. And as the word developed, Barnabas felt a need of suitable help in order to grow and spread the word of God. He went to Tarsus and seek for Paul as a helping hand.
In a huge city of Antioch, Paul also found an excellent field of labor.
His learning, wisdom, energy added a powerful influence over the people of the help that proved just the help Barnabas needed.
For a year, the two disciples worked together, united in Christ in faithful ministry and tell too many about Jesus of Nazareth, the world's Redeemer.
Slowly but surely, Antioch became a second home for Christians. This is where the name Christians was first used because Christ was their main theme in their preaching, their teaching, and their conversation.
They talked about the incident that had occurred during the days of his earthly ministry when the disciples were blessed with his personal presence, how the disciples dwelt upon his healing and his miracles of healing.
With trembling lips and tearful eyes, they spoke of his agony in the garden.
They remember his God-like pity with which he had when he prayed for those who persecuted him, his resurrection, ascension, and all his work as the mediator of heaven, were topics on which they rejoiced to dwell.
Well, may it be the heathen that called them Christians, since they preach Christ and addresses their prayer to God through him.
No. It was God who gave it to them, the name Christian. This is a royal name given to all who join themselves to Christ, like you and us here.
The believers at Antioch realized that God was willing to work in their lives, both to will and to do of his good pleasure.
And so, in their humble ministry, they learned to depend upon the power of the Holy Spirit and to make effective words of life. And so, in their various walks of life, they daily bore testimonies in their faith in Christ.
The work of Paul together with Barnabas strengthens his conviction that God had called him to do a special work in the Gentile world.
God had abundantly blessed the labors of Paul and Barnabas during the year they remained with the Antioch in believers. But for today, where's our focus?
Boys and girls, that means that they were allowed to preach the truth, not only to the Gentiles, but please, boys and girls, let us remember our prayers.
Like how mom trusts me to cook for the family, or when dad trusts me with my siblings.
Yes, but greater, the shepherds are given all they need to bring back the lost sheep.
Because of his life of his present, Jesus also told them to bow down and worship God.
As an example of them is when an animal was given sacrifice, the hand was priestly authorized was raised upon the hand of the animal head.
Ecclesiastical, what might that be?
Yes, ecclesiastical. This is just another word for church authority. You get it now, right?
Right. The church ministry was currently entering an important era, an important time of change.
In God's divine and guidance, he places his servants among the high and the low.
The apostle who had been chosen to lead out this work will be exposed to suspicion, bias, and jealousy. That means they lost their friends and people are jealous of them.
Now, boys, these were ordained in public to show their divine appointment and to witness to the Gentiles the glad tidings of the gospel.
And because of the good work of the apostle, during the year they remained with the believers, many Jews from all land came to worship at the temple in Jerusalem.
Faithfully and wisely, they longed to see the second coming of the promised Messiah, the hope of Israel.
How can I fail to understand that? I can even add, when the minister of the apostle of the believers in Antioch laid their hands on Paul and Barnabas, they by this action asked God to bestow his blessing on the chosen apostle in devotion in the specific work in which they will be appointed.
I see people are shining here. Today, God has built his church on the earth's channel of light, and through it, he communicates his purpose and his will. He does not give to one of his servants experience contrary to the experience of church itself.
Correct. Neither does he give his one man a knowledge of it for the entire church, while the entire church is left in darkness.
Boys and girls, what is your talent and how will you use it to bring the lost back to God?
Do you have time for Jesus? Do you have room for Jesus? Labor for Jesus, and you shall have great joy when you shall meet with Jesus.
At this time, the light of the gospel was shining brightly, and the other important work was done by the apostles who had remained in Jerusalem.
Our talents are greatly required for the church service in ministry. Time is rapidly passing, and there is much work to be done. Make good use of your work while it's still day, for the night is coming when no man shall work at all.
Wasting all your precious house,
can you not work for Jesus?
Thank you for the sermon, and may those who are listening to us, may they understand it. Forgive us our sins. God help us through this journey. And this is our prayer. Amen.
Amen.
Thank you, boys and girls, for joining us this sermon. Next time, please join us as we study about the heroes of the gospel. But for now,
bye.